Dear friends, welcome all in MSc Second Computer Science Online class on behalf of Maratha Vidya Prasarak Samaj, KTG Employer Nasik and Computer Science Department. Already you know that because of lockdown process, Government of Maharashtra and Savitribai Phule Pune University has taken the decision to start MSc Computer Science Second from August 2020. We have to conduct online teaching. You have entered in MSc Second, and in MSc Second also, the pattern and conduct of every process along with examination is same as that of MSc First, and you know that. For MSc Second, you have three core theory courses, one departmental theory plus practical course and one core practical. I, Bharat Darekar, will conduct paper 1, Software Architecture and Design Patterns, whose course code is CSUT231. That means compulsory university theory, and the code is 231. For this paper, in syllabus, we have to complete 8 chapters. First one is introduction, second software architecture, third architectural styles, fourth introduction to patterns, fifth study of design patterns, sixth general responsibility assignment, software patterns, seventh study of frameworks, and eighth case study, any one of the web architecture. To learn the syllabus, what is prerequisite here? Prerequisite means what you learn already and what you must know. Prerequisite for this course are Java, UML and object-oriented programming concepts, among which you already learned OOPS in second year and Java and UML concept in last year, that is TYVSC Computer Science. Our aim is to learn software architecture and design pattern, is to design the project development structure in an efficient way. And objective of this course, to learn various techniques and methods to manage the project structures and workflow. So thank you for this introduction of this paper, and welcome again. Stay home, stay safe and be connected. So we'll start Software Architecture and Design Patterns, whose course code is CSUT231. We'll see first chapter, introduction. Here in syllabus, we'll see what we have to cover in chapter 1. 1.1 is UML, the notation. 1.2, process unified process / rational unified process inception, elaboration, construction, transition. 1.3 is how various components fit in the life cycle, the artifacts at end of each process / discipline. Here we have to cover these points. We'll see first primary concept. Here IEEE, the Institute of Electrical and Electronic Engineers, and it is a professional association for electronic engineering and electrical engineering and associated disciplines also. UML diagram. So what is UML diagram? It is a diagram based on the UML. UML means Unified Modeling Language, with the purpose of visually representing a system along with its main actors, roles, actions, artifacts or classes, in order to better understand, alter, maintain or document information about the system. So here, regarding the UML diagram, that is Unified Modeling Language diagram, UML is a standard modeling language, not a software development process. Then we see the another concept, RUP, that is Rational Unified Process, and it is a software development process from Rational, a division of IBM. It divides the development process into four distinct phases that each involve business, modeling, analysis and design, implementation, testing and deployment. Here UML notations. What is UML? We all know that UML is for visualizing, specifying, constructing and documenting the components of software and non-software systems. Hence, visualization is the most important part which needs to be understood and remembered. Then what is UML notations? UML notations are the most important element in modeling. Efficient and appropriate use of notations is very important for making a complete and meaningful model. The model is useless unless its purpose is depicted properly. Then next is
That means there are many notations for different information and relationship. UML diagrams are made using notations. UML notations and diagrams are for understanding the project structure. UML helps in analyzing the process of project development. Here, types of notations: classes, objects, interface, collaboration, use case, active classes, components. What are structured things? Structural things, graphical notations used in structural things are most widely used in UML. So we'll see following are the list of structural things. Or first, what are structural things? Again, a class notation is a type of static structure diagram that describes the structure of a system by showing all the system and relationship between them. We'll see the class diagram. Here you already know that, and you have learned in when you learn the object oriented programming language, that is C++, and in third year you seen that is in Java and PHP also we have used class. Here we'll see the structure of that class. First one here, company, that means company is the name of a class. Then the attributes of class. Here we have given, or we have taken as example, company number, that is C number, company name, C phone, that is company phone, and here company number is an integer, that is type is integer. Company name, it is a type of company name is string, and company phone, again type is integer. Here you remember that you have seen that the visibility, that is protected, public and private. Public means it is visible to all. And when you say the private, so it is visible for only that class. And when you say the protected, then it is only particular for that class and also the derived class. So here are, that is protected, public and private. We have used C number, C name and C4. Then the operations of that class, that is here we use many operations. Here we have taken insert, update, delete or view all. So these are the operations. Then in structure we may give the additional operations also. Here manipulate information, that means this is an optional field and we may add here the additional operations also. Object notation. The object notation shows the object that are derived from the class, and you also learn in when you learn the object oriented programming language. Here again we'll see how that object will be shown. So it is very similar which we have seen previously. Here only the difference is here the name, it is underlined. That means company is the name and we have underlined it. Then again the here the attributes and the operations. Here additional operations are not given, that is which is a optional, we saw previously. So here the company ID, company name and company phone, again the type integers, string and big integer. Here we have already seen the same, here these are the attributes. And the operations again, insert, update, delete and show all. Only the difference is here name is with underline. Then the interface notation. Here interface is shown by using a circle. And here we have shown that this is a interface. And here it is the company application, that means company name. Here company application is the name of the interface and company name here, C name. Use case notations. Use case is shown in a Eclipse shape. Here it is a company register. This is a name for use case. Component notation. Here in the diagram you can see that how the component notation is given, and here the name of this component is organization. Then active class notation. Here we'll see active class notation. Here in the figure it is given that company, which is a name. Then again the attributes here, C name, then the
C URL
and C address. Here again the all are the string types. Then the here add EMP, that means the operations. Here the employee, for addition of employee, here we have taken the operation, that is the add EMP, and the attributes and the name which already we discuss. Here it is the package notation. This is the title and how the package notation. Here it is, that is the component. Here it is a notation. Name is a component, and this all you can say that it is a package.
Rational unified process.
When we start this chapter, I told some concepts, and at that time also I discussed rational unified process. Here it is software engineering process. The order steps to achieve the goal of developing a software or enhancing it. The rational unified process, again here we will see each iteration consists of one or more of the following steps. First, requirements capture. Second, analysis. Third, design. Fourth, implementation. And the fifth, test. Unified process model. Here, this is the diagram, and we explain this diagram. We discuss concepts, business modeling, requirements, analysis, implementation, test, deployment. And here again, inception, elaboration, construction, and transition. And here it is a flow according to that. We'll see first what are these concepts. Business modeling. Here it is a domain object modeling of dynamic modeling of the business process. Then requirements. Requirements analysis of system under construction includes activities like writing, use case, and identifying non-functional requirements. Then the another analysis and design. It covers aspect of design, including the overall architecture. Next, implementation, programming and building the system, except the deployment. Then the test. Here it involves testing activities such as test planning, development of test scenario, alpha and beta testing, regression testing, acceptance testing. And the last, that is deployment, the deployment activities for of deployment system. Here we'll see this again. In business modeling, you can see there also in the figure, in business modeling, requirement and analysis, initially there is a more work. You can see in the figure also, graphically it is shown. And as the project moves to the end, the work is less. So hence here, according to the graph, you can see. Then in next, that is in implementation and testing, the work is done for each model deployed. And the deployment work is more at the end of the project. Here you can see in the figure also. Next is life cycle. Here concepts are inception, elaboration, construction, transition. We'll see this inception. This phase is used for the scope of the project and develop business case. Second one is elaboration. This phase helps in planning the project, specify features and baseline of the architecture. Third is construction. This phase is used to build the product. And fourth is transition. Deploy the product to user. The artifacts at end of each process or discipline. We'll discuss this concept. Here the development case. That means here I will explain one development case, which case of UP artifacts is given. Here the choice of UP artifacts for a project may be written up in a short document called the development case. That is an artifact in the environment discipline. Here that could be the development case describe the artifacts, and whatever the example I will going to explain you. In that example, artifacts presented in that case study are by no means sufficient for or suitable for all projects. Remember these things. Then we'll see here in this discipline artifacts: inception, elaboration, constant, and transition. So we'll see. We are discussing the artifacts at end of each process or discipline. Here it is: when discipline is business modeling and artifact is domain model, then here elaboration is start and other nothing is there. Then when discipline is requirement and artifact is use case model, then inception is start and elaboration is refined. Okay, then next, when the discipline is design and artifacts is design model, or it is software architecture document data model, then here again elaboration is start and constant is refined. Then when software architecture document is there, then elaboration is start, and when data model is there, then elaboration is start and constant is refined. Then when discipline is implementation and artifact is implementation model, then elaboration start and constant refined, and transition also refined. Then when discipline is project management and artifact is software development plan, then inception is start, elaboration is refine, constant is refine, and again transition is refine. Then when discipline is testing and artifact is test model, then elaboration is start and constant refine. Then when discipline is environment and artifact is development case, then in this case inception start, elaboration refine. So here we'll discuss the software chapter in terms of question base, means what type of questions may be asked in the examination. So we'll see according to that. Here the first question, which are the most commonly used modeling techniques. So there are three modeling techniques. First one is static modeling, second is dynamic modeling, and third one is architectural modeling. Here we'll see in detail what is static modeling. Static modeling enables you to define the core building blocks of the system under design. The various building blocks used to develop the static view of a model are, suppose the things, here we can say that the classes. Then the relationship, here we say that the dependency, generalization, and association. Then the diagram, here class diagram and the object diagrams. Then the next is dynamic modeling. Objects do not stay idle in all systems. They tend to interact with other elements. The dynamic nature of a system is modeled as the flow of control. For example, you can say when designing a car, you provide details such as body, doors, windows, engine, battery, and wheels. These details provide another model of a car. Talking the dynamic aspect such as wind and road conditions into account result in an efficient model of a car. Interaction diagrams, use case diagrams, activity diagrams, and state chart diagrams reflect the dynamic behavior of a system. Then, architectural modeling. Architecture provides an abstract description of the organizational and structural decision apparent in a system. Architectural modeling requires the decomposition of a system into subsystems, distributing control and responsibility, and defining the components and means of communication between them. As the trend in software continues towards increasingly large and complex systems, it is important that you model the architecture of these systems in a standardized way. The fundamental purpose of architectural modeling is to promote the evaluation of the system and provide a basic idea of the system before you create concrete parts. You can reflect the changes or details of the parts as the system develops. Next question, what are the four phases specified in RUP? Explain any one in brief. When we discuss the theory, we discuss every four phases, but here we will see in detail how you can write. First is inception phase, then the elaboration phase, construction phase, and transition phase. Here are the four phases in rational unified process. We'll see the first phase, that is inception phase. Here we see this phase in detail, and you can write if you want to write the all phases, but here in question only one is asked. We'll see here first inception phase. The focus of activities in the initial phase of a RUP implementation project is on clearly defining the vision and scope for implementing RUP process in the organization and securing the necessary support and funding for the project through the organization's executive management. Here the key activities, the primary work in defining the scope of the process implementation is analyze the business problem, determine the high level business goals and objectives of adopting RUP in the organization and record them in a business vision document. Develop a business case document to request funding to access the organization's current system development process. Conduct an organization assessment. Here you can say, assess the current organization process and development environment to determine what changes are needed to meet the business goals and objectives for the RUP implementation. From this assessment, identify the development organization's key business process needs as they relate to RUP. Priorities the business needs, and from these needs, identify the high-level features and architecture you need to configure and or customize RUP. The feature list and architecture description should identify any new or modified RUP process elements and any process elements that will not be needed. Revise the business case to include the effort to develop configuration of RUP that are required to meet the needs of the organization, and then present the business case to executive management to secure funding for this purpose. Here the planning, that means defining the tasks needed to implement the defined process configurations. You should develop the process configuration in an interactive manner and prioritize the process implementation according to the organization's most urgent needs. Life cycle objectives. The inception phase for a RUP implementation project ends with a review of the final business case for the proposed RUP configuration. Configuration development by the executive management stakeholders. In some cases, this represents the second go or no-go milestone in the inception phase, as they may have been an earlier go or no-go review for the initial business case. In order to obtain funding for the development organization assessment. And the second is elaboration phase. Here you can see, as I told, that we have discussed in detail when we see the theory of elaboration phase. Here remember that the key activities for this is the primary work items in these phases. Next, that is construction phase. Here also you remember that the key activities, that means the primary work items in the construction phase, that means you have to mention in your answer. And the transition phase also, you have to mention that the whatever the primary work activities during this phase. Next question, explain UP disciplines. Here in UP discipline, you can say the UP describes work activities such as writing a use case within discipline, or you can say the originally called workflows. A discipline is a set of activities in one subject area, such as the activities within requirement analysis. In the UP, an artifact is the general term for any work product. Code, web graphics, database schema, text documents, diagrams, models, and so on. There are several disciplines in the UP. We can see business modeling, requirements, design, implementation, tests, development, configuration and change management, project management, and environment. We'll see one by one. Business modeling. When developing a single application, this includes domain objective modeling. When engaged in large scale business analysis or business process re-engineering, this includes dynamic modeling of the business process across the entire enterprise. Next is the requirements. Requirements analysis for an application, such as writing use cases and identifying non-functional requirements. Next phase is design. Here, all aspects of design, including the overall architecture, objects, databases, networking, and the like one. Next is the implementation, means programming and building the system, not development. Then the test. Test means here, whatever the software you build, the testing of that software. And the next is the development. Development means whenever you are in testing, if you find any problem, they develop in these phases. Then the next is configuration and change management. That means whatever you found in test and development, and if you want to change your configuration, then accordingly you can change the configuration, and hence the change management also. Then next, the project management. That means whenever you build any software, any program or whatever, then regarding the management side, you have to see whole project management here. Then the environment. That means here, according to you, in your environment, this software works very well. but you have to say for your client that you check in your environment. That means whether it is okay in the client's environment also. Next question, define. Here we'll see what are the terms. First one is the UML. UML, short for Unified Modeling Language, is a standardized modeling language consisting of an integrated set of diagrams developed to help system and software developers for specifying, visualizing, constructing and documenting the artifacts of software systems, as well as for business modeling and other non-software systems also. Next definition is Unified Process Model. The Unified Process Model, or you can say the UPM, is an interactive, incremental, architecture-centric and use case-driven approach to software development. Let's first take a look at the use case-driven approach. Next is Rational Unified Process Model. The RUP development methodology provides a structural way for companies to envision, create software programs, since it provides specific plan for each step of the development process. It helps prevent resources from being wasted and reduces unexpected development costs.